Hope you have listened to the song Celluloid Heroes, which is a song presented by a professional troupe, sees cinema as a part of popular culture and goes to the extent of suggesting, I wish my life was a non-stop Hollywood movie show. The song is in a way of an admirer's subjective analysis of the film dom. Why song? India le cinema eduthu nokki kaiyal adile paattu valare era pradhanamullayi thonnund edu malayala cinema ayalum hindi cinema ayalum paattu kondu thanne oru paadu scene nam kaanan kayum. But in world cinema songs are not used as widely as they are in our films. This song successfully depicting many subtle notions of cinema which make it the most popular art form of the contemporary world. Next is regarding the evaluation. While we were discussing the first and second unit, how the evaluation is done in the case of poetry, we have seen the same strategy is used in the case of song also. Here reads, analyzes and appreciate the poem is to be evaluated. The strategy for evaluating is taking as, here is a sample question for that one. Read the following lines from Celluloid Heroes and answer the questions that follow, that followed. Everybody is a dreamer and everybody is a star and everybody is in movies, it does not matter who you are. There are stars in every city, in every house and on every street. And if you walk down Hollywood, Bollywood, then their names were written in concrete. These are the lines of that Celluloid Heroes and the questions you just see. What does the expression everybody is in movies signify? Factual one. In what scene is everybody is a star? Which place is referred to in these lines? The line, their names are written in concrete, can suggest two meanings, explain. So again the learner has to interpret that very word in both critically he has to see that word also. And after that evaluation of the poetry, here the song, we are passing on to the language element area. An activity to sensitize the stylistic variations of the sentence are given here. One example is like here, for him the tea shop is a trading center, for him comma the tea shop is a trading center. Usually this sentence is written as the tea shop is a trading center for him. Here the for him is taken first and after that sentence is made. So it gives a style of, it creates a stylistic writing. There are some other examples are here. The man told me many a story of adventure. Try to change it like this. Many a story of adventure the man told me. Next example is, I finished a huge piece of work in a short time. That can be rewritten as like this. In a short time, I finished a huge piece of work. So you may expect a question like this, change the style of sentence. So that if the example is given the same thing, the man told me many a story of adventure, your answer must be in such a way that many a story of adventure the man told me. The meaning is not changing, but that's a chunk is moved from first position to the last position. So there what is happening, the style of the sentence is created. This the same thing we have discussed in the case of class 9 and 8 while we are analyzing the story, we discussed this one. Beginning the sentence with it to emphasize. Manoj plays cricket on Sundays. That sentence can be, if you want to give emphasize on Sundays, it is on Sundays Manoj plays cricket. It is cricket Manoj plays on Sundays. Here what is happening, cricket is emphasized. We are passing on to one area of analytical grammar. This is the highlight of the textbook and we are passing a word is here, boy, the tall boy in the class. the tall boy in the class who won the prize. So, up to this one, this is a phrase, it is a noun phrase with boy has the head noun. The tall boy in the class who won the prize come to school. When come to school, comes to school comes, it is a verb phrase as the comes as the head verb. The tall boy in the class who won the prize come to school on a bicycle, and here comes to school on a bicycle comes under a verb phrase. The tall boy in the class who won the prize comes under a noun phrase. So, here we can make this analysis like this. The first 5 steps in the pyramid expands the noun phrase, but noun phrase alone cannot make a sentence. From 6th step onwards, a verb phrase has been added to the noun phrase, thus making them sentence. Basically, every sentence is a combination of a noun phrase and a verb phrase that are meaningfully linked. So, we have discussed in detail the entry text, the main text, the extended text, and also the poem and language element area we discussed, and try to read the textbook and do the exercises. And I wish you all the best. Thank you. Thank you very much.